Too big for my shirt.
This is for all my little queers who were never taught how to tie a tie. I'm your dad now. Okay, so first things first, there's a beefy end and a little end. You want to make sure the beefy end is like twice as long as the little end. And I personally like to make my knot where they become kind of the same size. So you're going to take the beefy end and pull it over to the side, okay, in a straight line. And then you're going to bring it back behind the little end, back to the side again, and then you're gonna pull it over one more time, okay? And then you're gonna flip it back over like that, okay? And then you'll notice you made like a little pocket. So you're gonna tuck the beefy end in the little pocket and pull it through. When you pull on the beefy end, you can adjust the size of the knot, and when you pull on the little end, you adjust how long it is. Excuse me. So yeah, that's how you tie a tie. I hope you guys have a good day. Send this to a queer who needs it. I love you. Have a, yep, nice.
Of course, I can teach you how to tie a tie. You guys know I love being a big brother figure for all of my family here on TikTok, trans and cis alike. I'm gonna be teaching you how to do the most basic, easy way to tie a tie, okay? First step, just button your shirt up all the way to the very tippity top so you look like a huge dork, okay? Pop that collar up and grab your tie. You're gonna put the big side on your dominant side, it's the hand you write with, and make it way longer than the short end, okay? You're gonna take the big end, you're gonna wrap it over top and around the short end, okay? Like this. Not once, but twice. Pop it up through this part near your neck. Then you're gonna grab the end of it, stick it through this little loop we made, and pull it right through. You're then gonna pull that to tighten the knot. Pull on this little skinny one on the back to bring it up all the way to your throat. I mean, don't like choke yourself or anything. And then pop your collar down, and you, my friend, know how to tie a tie.
Here's how to tie a tie in under 8 seconds. Step 1, drape the tie over your hand. Step 2, wrap it around once and make sure it does the line. Step 3, wrap it around one more time and leave a little gap right in the middle. Step 4, grab the furthest piece to the right to create a gap, like so. Just be aware that for the next step, you're going to be pulling the middle piece. Step 5, pull it through and pull up, creating a loop up top. And pull down on the widest part of the tie. Begin to adjust your knot to make sure it's up to your liking.
Hi guys, today I'm gonna teach you how to tie a tie. So first, you're gonna flip the little part over the big part, and you're gonna make an X on your knee. Take the big part, and you're gonna put it up through the middle, and you're gonna pull it through. Let it hang, keep that little part held. You're gonna take this, throw it over to your left, and bring it underneath the tie, still holding that little part. You're gonna throw it back up and back down into the tie. Then you're gonna throw it across. And then it's gonna go back up into the middle of the tie. And now, you're gonna take the big part and tuck it into the outermost like layer of your tie knot that you made. And then pull, adjust, little tugs, and you have a tie.
Here's how she don't wanna leave.
Don't give up on me. I belong with you. Don't
gonna say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh.
What you know about rolling down in the deep? When your brain goes numb, you can call that mental freeze. When these people talk too much, put that shit in slow motion. Yeah, I feel like an astronaut in the ocean. Ay, what you know about rolling down in the deep? When your brain goes numb, you can call that mental freeze. When these...
Alright guys, so today we're gonna have an edumacational video because TikTok is deleting my other video, so I'm gonna edumacate you guys on how to tie a tie so you can be a professional fool just like me. So basically you're gonna get the big thingy and you're gonna put it through a little thingy. And then the size of the thingies, it's kinda hard to figure out the first time, so you're just gonna have to figure it out every time you go. But then you get the thingy, you put it through the other hole of the thingy, and then once you bring it to the front of the thingy, and then you can just put it through the hole. But make sure you put it through the right hole, because if you put it through the wrong hole, she's gonna scream. I mean, the tie's gonna come out wrong, and you don't want it to come out wrong. So then once you put it through this thingy, then you can just tie it up, right? And then you can shape it by pinching it down here, and then to tighten it, you just put it all the way up. And then the secret is, once you're done, you know, you fold this down, whatever, but once you're done, you're just gonna go like this and you take it off. So next time you can just put it on, and then you don't fucking have to be, you know, struggling to tie it. Come on, my boy, that's a crispy ass tie right there. Look, and I know you probably didn't have a dad to teach you how to fucking tie a tie, but I didn't either. I fucking learned on YouTube, so you know what? You can still be a professional fool.
Dad. Yeah. Can you show them how to tie a Windsor knot now?
Well, first, let me get my collar stays in.
Okay.
All right, so first of all, this is King Edward VIII, the Duke of Windsor. That's where this comes from. Okay. Cross it over, right? Fat part over the thin. This way underneath.
Okay.
Coming on top over here. Got there. And we come back under this way. We're going to go back on the other side. See? Both sides are covered.
That's the double part.
The double part. One, two. Now we're going to bring it back across the front this way.
Okay.
Yeah? Yeah? Come up and through here. We're going to feed it down. And we're going to play around. Pull it. Feel nice and tight. Tight. Boom. One shot. Everyone knows. Wow, okay, this is a little fatter, a little shorter. Gotta use the spread collar. This is a different collared shirt. It's a shorter collar. I hope it looks good. This has all been, right? How's that look,
man? Yeah, great.
Tight, good.
Looks good to me.
Take the flap in the back,
tuck it in
through here. That's what this is for, okay?
All right,
put my jacket on, cuff it up.
All right, good job.
Get out of here.
Dad. Why don't you teach our friends here how to tie a tie?
Perfect timing, because I'm doing it. Step one, pop the collar, like we did in the 80s.
Yeah, sure.
Button it, put the tie on like this. Fat part, thin part.
Okay.
Cross the fat over the thin. Take the fat part, bring it under.
Okay.
And then we're gonna come back across.
Yeah, five. The five.
Bring it up through this way.
Okay.
Again, seams down, boom. Okay, take this tail,
okay.
Hold it open so you pull it through the knot you just made in the front. Look, how nice. I like to pinch here and pull. So do a little pinching and pulling. You guys seen this come together? Fast. Collar down. Nice and tight. We should be ready to go.
Looking good. Thanks, man.
They tell me, girl, you the best, but I already know what I am. They know I only wanna come over, put it on them. I got that whoa, na na na. He drink that shit like water.
Absolutely. So you're gonna grab the bigger part of the tie, and you're going to cross it over the smaller part of the tie, and then you're going to flip it around. And then you see how you created like a little loop when you flipped it around? Just take this and pull it through behind, and then just tuck it through the loop. And then do, pull. And then if you hold on to this and then you pull up this part, that's kind of how it works. And then just pull your collar over. And it depends how long you make the tie, but there probably will be some of the smaller part hanging over. And what we used to do in secondary school is we would just tuck it into our shirt and like pass the skirt so it's like like that. Hope that helped.
What?
I'm going to show you how I tie a tie today. First thing you do is make an X. We're going to call the long end the big fish. Short end is the little fish. Pinch it in the middle. Then the big fish is going to swim around the rock. Then the big fish is going to swim on the back side of the rock. Come over the top. I know it's hard to see. And the big fish is going to drop down through the waterfall. Then you cinch it up. Now the big fish should always be bigger than the little fish when you get done, or you need to start over.
Okay, my turn.
Okay, your turn.
Okay, so this is how you do. This straight it up like this.
Yeah.
The mountain makes water to make the waterfall go. And then make
a lot of people have asked this, so here's how you tie a tie. Left side of your body, right side of your body. It depends on how long you want your tie, but you usually want this side fairly shorter than this side. And this is the tying part. So this side goes over and under. I like to rest it on my arm and then grab it again, flip it back over, go through. I kind of use my mouth, unsanitary, but to do that, you put it through the big loop that was just created, pull it down, and hold this bottom one, pull this one up. This is why you want this one shorter, because you'll have some extra leash. But if you have like a button-up t-shirt, just tuck it inside and you're good. Tie, tie, tie.
Okay, I was asked to do this because they see me do it before and I didn't explain it. Short end here, for me, it's usually about right here. This will never move, the tie will always go around. So you go over, under, you go through, you go around the front, and then through the back, you go through, and then you tuck through here, the very front. That's a full Windsor, keeps the knot square. When you pull this down, you want to make sure that the small is behind the front, and then you tuck it in. I do not have a tie clip, which I will be purchasing to help hold it right here. But that's how you tie a full Windsor, tuck it down. You got a square. The half Windsor is a crooked knot,